Hi everybody, welcome back to the channel. Eddie here from Always Be Fun. Nice to see us again. Today I would like to show you how to replace the RG350 IPS screen from 32x24 to 640x480 IPS screen. To replace this 640x480 IPS screen, we will need to replace the hardware and software both together. Hardware is the screen display and software is the display driver. Before we get started, please don't forget to subscribe our channel, like the video and share the video. This is the part and tools to fix our 640x480 IPS screen. The 640x480 IPS screen, our RG350, a Phillips screwdriver, and a plier or tweezer. We need to disassemble the RG350 first. So we need to turn off the console and remove the four Phillips screwdriver from the back cover. After we remove the back cover, we need to disconnect the battery, analog stick ribbon, display ribbon, and remove total of 6 screws from the logic board. Now we can remove our logic board. We no need to remove our speaker, we just take our screen out and replace with a new screen. I will use a tape to help stick on the button. We can fix all back together. We have finished the display LCD, but don't think that this is over. For hardware, yes, this is the process to replace the LCD display, but you still need to replace the display driver from the card. So we don't fix all the back cover and battery first. We remove the card and plug in to our laptop or computer PC with a card reader. First, you need to download the RG350M display driver from the link. I already download and create a folder named as RG350 on my laptop desktop. Open the folder and choose the RG350M folder. The RG350M file is largest compared with the RG350 display driver file. Now we copy RG350M display driver file and go to your SD card folder. Once you click into the SD card folder, you will see a same file named as vmlinux.bin. Paste it and replaste it. After you replace the file, now you can save, remove the SD card from your computer and put back the SD card to your console. After you copy and replace the display driver, now we can put back our memory card to the console and our battery and back cover, or we can fix it back. This battery is stick to the back cover, but because I always like to disassemble the console, that's why I remove it from the back cover. Now our console is ready. We can power on. Now we have a high resolution 640x480 IPS screen for our RG350. We do need to replace the display driver. If without the display driver, we may get a blank screen or blue screen only. It won't show any display. I will put the link on the description below for the display driver. You can go and download from it. For some game, the high resolution IPS screen is better than the original IPS screen. How do you think? Please do leave us the comment below. Today our video will end here. Hope you enjoy it. See you on next video. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.